this is the case which we create, right? So A6007 is your case ID, which will be storing in a property called as PYID. Okay, that's a unique ID, unique ID which was given. So this A is your first letter of your case type. Okay, so whenever something is added, I mean something is provided in your case data, that would be saved into DB, right? But is it possible to see your database how it is? It won't be possible for you to check. So, but to know what are the things happening in the back end, Pega has provided you with the temporary memory space, which is called as clipboard. So this is a clipboard. So clipboard is a temporary memory, temporary memory space where you can view all your case data or your system data also, to which system you have logged in, on which node you are working, whether this environment is a development environment or it is a staging environment. You can see all those things in your clipboard. So it's a debugging tool where you can view the data. Your all data can be viewed over there. Okay, which is a replica of your DB, not complete DB, a part of one table. Okay, so let me open this clipboard. So when you open this clipboard, thread is important, as you know, right? So thread A6007 is important. And now in this, there are many pages. You can see user pages, data pages, link property pages, and system pages. And in the system pages, you have operator ID details. Okay, this is a page. We call this as a page here. In clipboard, you have many pages. So out of them, operator ID is one of the page. What is the class of this operator ID? Data-admin-operator-id, or operator-id is the class for this. So why I'm telling you this is, so if you look into here, you can see what is the operator name, PY user identifier would be there. Okay, yeah, operator name, what is the username, what is, let me open my operator here. Okay, and this, and we also see your clipboard. Okay, your full name, okay, and your email ID. So we'll see whether these all things are there or not. So if you expand, there would be PY address. In this PY address, you'll see your PY email address, this one. Okay, so all this data, whatever, to whom, with which operator you are being logged in, that data would be available under the system pages in operator ID page. Now there might be a requirement where, okay, there might be a requirement where you want to have all this data in another page, in some other page in your under your case, in your case. So like this, this is your case, right? So I'm sorry, this is your case. Maybe here patient name or gender or reference, this DOB, age, these all things should come from your operator only. Okay, then how do you copy that? Okay, so data is available in operator. Data is available in operator, and this data should be copied into your user pages. Under user pages, you have something called as PY work page. So here you want it. In this you want. Okay, in this you want. In this particular page you want. So how do you copy that? Okay, so for that, Pega is offering you, or Pega is providing you with a rule called as data transform. Okay, so data transform is used to copy or manipulate your data. So from one page to the other page, it can be from one case to another case also. Okay, so maybe that time also we'll use, means everywhere, where, anywhere, if you find you have to assign something and you want to copy the data, then the first rule should strike in your mind is data transform. How do you do that? And where do you use that and all those things? It's up to you. Okay, but when something is coming into the coming as a requirement as copying the things, then definitely data transform should strike it in your mind. Okay, so how do you do that, or how do you configure, where do you call this data transform and all, we have seen, right? When we have learned it, We didn't see it, but yes, you can use it in flow rule as a connector shape, in a connector shape, or a flow action tab in pre or post processing. In a section layout, you can see, we have seen this, right? In section layout. Okay, you can call even in one data transform also. In another data transform also, you can call this. Okay, or you can call your data transform in a data page, or even you can call it in your activity also. Okay, so while we learned about this, what we did is, in our previous session, we copied the temporary address into the permanent address. That is one sample, I mean, simple exercise which we did. Okay, I'll write something over here, and this will be, when I select this, that would be copied into the permanent address. So this I did through the section. In section, there was an event and action, so I went to event and action and I worked on it upon selecting this. Means of, when I click this, something should happen. When I click this, something should happen. So that was an event and action. Event is what? Click is an event. Action is what? Copying the data. So that we did in the previous session, right? So now, to understand more about data transform, see, this is what data transform we did. When it is true, you add it, or when, if it is false, then make it as blank. That is what we did. Can you see? When it is true, add it. When it is false, you know, it is giving you the empty things. Okay, so this is what data transform which we have written. But will you do only this, or more than that you will do? Means yes, we do more than this data transform. I mean, more than these actions, like when, set, otherwise. Other than these things, we have some other actions also. What are those? So how to add a step? To add a step, you have to click on this plus here, or you can just simply select the row, right click on it, and you can see add sibling below and above. So you just select like this. If you don't want this particular first step, if you don't want this first step not to work, then you can just right click on it and you can make it as disable. When you select disable, it will be not executed. It will not execute at all. So you can even do disable. Whenever you disable, you can see that here, just disabled mode. So even you can enable it. Okay, so these are the things which you need to know it, because there might be certain data transforms which you want to customize. Means Pega has already given some data transform, you want to customize it. So at the time of customization, you should check whether, you know, whether it is enabled or disabled. So make it enabled. You have to right click on your step and see these all things. Okay, you want to copy the same third one. You want to copy, don't write again and again, just simply select the step which you want to copy, select it and write paste below or paste above. Simply it will copy. So that also can be happened. So just look into these options. Okay, when you are practicing, look into these options. Yeah, so now what I'm telling you is so when you add a step here, under actions we have so many things. Can you see? Set, there is a remove, there is an update page, there is an apply data transform, there is a sort, comment, you have when, you have otherwise, when you have. Okay, so append to and append and map to for each page, in exit for each, and and you got something called as exit data transform. So these many things are available in your in the actions. Okay, actions of data transform. So in your, you know, interviewers, I mean, interviewers will be mostly asking you on these two things: what is append to and append and map to. What happens when you, when to use append to and when to use append and map to. So we'll be looking into this also. So before that, we see other things. One is remove. Okay, so what happens when I use remove? Okay, whenever I write remove, okay, so whenever I write remove, and let me write address. This is a page group property, so that's why I have to write permanent like this. Save. Okay, and let's go back here. See what is happening here? Can you see, even though I select this, it's not working. Okay, so okay, so for your sake I'll write like this. What happened now? Tell me what happened. Whatever the data you have given, it has been removed. Yes, so what do you mean by remove option under data transform? Whenever you write remove, okay, it will remove that page, whatever you have written here. Okay, it will remove it from here, it will remove it from the clipboard. Okay, so I'll write HN over here. Can you see? It removed that property. So it removes that property from where? From the clipboard. So how do you know that? Go to clipboard and check PY work page. Here all case data will be available in PY work page, and address is a page group property, so definitely it would be inside the PY work page, that is embedded page of the PY work page. So expand this. You have address anywhere? If you see, address is gone. Okay, so now let me go to this and make this as disable. Save. Okay, you got this. Go to clipboard now. Okay, so let me continue and then see. Yes. Okay, so go back, enable this, save. Okay, go to this, go back. See the clipboard, address. Can you see? It removed the property also. Can you see? Street is there, but there is no what is it? It is not having the house number. Okay, so house number is not there. I'm giving house number here, 1, 2, 3 and all those things, and I'm selecting this, so it's gone. So continue. Go to clipboard and check the PY work page. Address, temporary, nothing is there. Permanent, everything is there. Why? Because in your copy address you have said that to remove the particular property. So remove, what it does, remove will remove the property from the clipboard. Okay, once your work is done, you don't want that particular property available in your clipboard, then you can just remove it, so that you know you will increase the memory of your clipboard. So you are reduce the memory of your clipboard. Okay, memory space is utilized properly. So what Pega always recommends you is, if you're creating any new page in your clipboard, better you remove once your work is done. That's the best practice. Okay, so when you create anything new after completion of your work and there is no work with that page, or there is nothing to be done with that new page which you created, better you delete it. Okay, don't keep it in the clipboard, so that you can utilize your clipboard memory space properly. So that is why in data transform they will give you something called as remove. So we have seen set, we have seen remove, and we can go for update page also. Okay, so update page. So whenever you go for update page, so in the name itself it is saying, right, page. Okay, so when, can you see here, when is temporary as permanent? Actually this is a page for us, right? It's a page group, right? It's a page group, and this is also page group. So instead of writing set, you can write directly update page. So update page, this page you update with values from another page. which page it is? That page you have to write here. Okay, so I saved it because 1.1 and all these things are empty, so that's why it is giving me an error. Yes, so when you update from one page to the other page, so you are updating. How do you update now? Set inset, what you write? You write dot house number, and here also dot house number. So it gives you these things now. Okay, what I'm saying is, when you feel it that this is a page property, okay, it's a single page property, then better use update page. So it can be same class or it can be different class. If you see here, dot hn, no, what is the class here? HMS hospital hyphen data hyphen address, and here also what is it? HMS hospital hyphen data hyphen. Both are of same properties, right? Both are referencing same data type. What are the data type I have here? They are referencing the same data type. So whenever it is same or whenever it is different, go for update page. So update page will update the properties, whatever the properties you have in this, into this particular thing. Okay, so let me create a property now. Let me create a property. We have already created two properties, guys, so don't get confused. So we have already created address property, which is a page group. Can you see here? Page group we created, that's why you got it. Now what I do is, I'll create another property, which is a single page. Okay, data model property, I'll say it as office address. Office address, create and open. It's a single page. I'll go with the address which is already there. I mean, I don't go with the one which is data dash address. Okay, so this is given by Pega, and this one is given by us. We created this address, but here data dash address is given by whom? By Pega. See this rule set, it is coming from Pega Procore. Okay, so it is given by Pega. So I'm reusing that property. So save. So now you got office address. Very good. So coming to here, I want to update now. So which page you want to update? You want to update office address. From values, from where? From address of temporary. So write dot. Okay, so what are the things you have here? PY create date is there, PY address is there. So we'll see. So these are all predefined properties, guys. Okay, which are there in what? Data dash address. See the class here. Your office address is referring to the data dash address. So in that, whatever the properties are there, it is taking that properties. Okay. I'm just checking which one I need to take. Can you see here country is there? So I'll take this property country, PY country, which I'll take it as house number, and next one is street, which is the one to check here. Street, yeah. Okay, I'm just telling you. See, this is of different class and this is of different class. Save. Okay, so now what I'm doing is, I'm updating this. I'm calling over here, even though I don't write those all things, but as I have clipboard, what I do is, I'll go there, expand PY work page. Can you see there is office address here? Can you see PY country has come here? So did you understand what is update page here? What is update page? Update page, whenever you think that you have to copy the data from one page property to the other page property and which are of different class, then better you go for update page. Office address, so don't get confused here, because you might be saying that office address and address both are of same class. Why are you saying that this is different class? Okay, so I'm not talking about the office address property or address property. I'm talking about something which it is being referenced. So what it is referenced? It is referencing data address, which is a different page definition, and the address whatever we saw. Okay, and that is referencing another class. What is that another class? HMS-hospital-data-address. See, both are of different classes, page properties which are having the different references. Then what you do is you go for what? Update page. If both are same, okay, if both are same, what you do? You can simply write set. If both are same, you write set. One page property data to another page data property which are different, then definitely you go for update page. Even if it is same also, you can go. Even if it is same also, you can update directly. So you want to update office address. How do you update? Dot PY country you can take, and from where you want to add dot address of temporary dot street, which is easy actually. You tell me which is easy, whether to write like this is easy or simply using values from and use this particular page over here, okay, and writing in this way is easy. So this is easy for us, where you can directly simply drop down the values and give it. Okay, so this is one way of updating the page or using the update page, right? So that is about update page. So what does update page will do is, update page will copy the data from one page to the other page, similar to set only, but it's a page. So we learned about set, remove, update page, apply data transform. What is this apply data transform? Apply data transform will apply, it will invoke another data transform over here. Okay, so let's see, apply data transform. Can you see here? It invokes another data transform, which comes within this class. Okay, whenever you have a same apply same data transform or another data transform over here, you can call them. So these are all certain data transforms which are there. The rest of them which are there in work dash, cover dash and work dash are predefined. Means these are all given by Pega. We didn't create them. This PY default and PY set feed default is given by Pega. Only copy address is the one which we created. Okay, so this will call another data transform. So that's what we said, right? In our, when we learned about what is data transform here. So what did we say? So you can call even it from the DT. Okay, so DT, how? Using apply data transform. Yes, so that is the next one, apply data transform. And next is coming to the sort. So what do you mean by sort? You want to sort a page, okay, according to the based upon their name, or based upon the some age. If you want to do that, yes, you can do using sort. So how do you do that? So how do you do that means? Let me run our case. So if we have any requirement where we can use page list property, or we have already used, so there we will add this. Yeah, we have, yes, sorry, we have here medical history. So maybe we can work on this medical history option. Okay, so for example, medication from BP. One year, what else we have? What else? Smoking, I'll write. Simply like this, I'll write. Okay, so now based on this, time period, I want to sort them. Okay, so next time or when I click on continue, it should come in a sorted manner, or else maybe I have a button over here. Maybe I have a button over here, and when I click on that button, it should show me in a sorted manner. Like now it is in descending order. Can you see here? Luckily, I gave in descending order, but you want them in ascending order. Okay, so then you can go with 1, 2, 5 like this. So how do you do that? Means you can use it using data transform. Okay, so how do you do that? Let us create one data transform, because I can't use the same thing here, because by that time, why I can't use same data transform? Because by this time I didn't provide medical history, right? So that's why I want to do it here itself. Okay, that's why I will go for a new one. So how to create data model, data transform. So what I want to do is I want to sort the medical history. Okay. Sort medical history. So I'm using this, create and so sort. What is the page list? Medical history. Okay, so how do I sort? There is a settings. Can you see here on this gear icon? Click on plus. So which property, on which property you want to do? I want to do it at time period, whether it is ascending or descending. Let me go with ascending. Save. Okay, so now you created this what is it, this particular data transform. Now what you have to do is you have to use this, because data transform is a procedural processing. Okay, so as it is a procedural processing, you have to create it, and then just give me a minute. So activity, data transform is procedural processing. So you have to create data transform, and then you have to invoke it. So how do you invoke? We have these all options, right? Where do you want to invoke? Whether you want to invoke in the connector shape, or we cannot use this because it is in it is in multi-step form, so we cannot use flow rule. Either we can go with this, or we can go with the layout, this one. So I prefer this one only here. I prefer this. Why do I prefer this? I want a button here. I want a button over here. When I click on that button, it should get what is that? It should sort the time period. Okay, so that I want to do it. My requirement is you need to have a button, so whenever user click on that button, it should sort according to the time period. So that's the requirement given to me. So how do I do that? So to do that, I need to open this particular section. So let me open the section. So how do I do that? It's easy. Two ways are there. So you can just expand, apply for assign appointment, and click on user interface, click on section, and here you can see where is my where is this collect patient diagnose medical history. So you can check like this. This is one way of checking or opening the section. So from here, or the other way, the best way is click on live UI, select this, just open this. See, it opens that, which is easy, searching or just going to live UI, basically live UI. So what is this live UI? Live UI is again a tool here, which is a development, I mean, it's a developer tool. What you do with live UI means at the time of runtime, or when you are during you are executing a particular case and you think that something need to be added or adjusted, or some label has given a wrong name, okay, and you want to do it at the execution time itself, means you can go with the live UI, so that your UI would be tracked and based on the section or whatever the property you have. So for example, I'll select this, maybe a patient history spelling is wrong. So what I can do is I can select this, click on settings, I can change the label patient history, I can directly change, but here this option is there because I'm using a template. But if you don't use a template, directly you can change here itself and close, automatically it gets updated here itself. So there is no need of going and opening rules and all those things. So live UI helps in that way. So now we are telling it as live UI. In the previous versions, we used to say it as UI inspector. Okay, so UI inspector from 6 version, it used to tell, we used to say it as UI inspector, but from 7 onwards, we are saying it as live UI. Okay, both are similar. So now what I want to add a button over here, which used to be sorted. So let me open this section. So in this is how the section looks like, guys. So you might be seeing two sections. This is one section. Can you see? This is also a section, right? This is also a section, and coming back to here, this is also a section. What is the difference here? This we are using as a template. Okay, can you see here template? I'm using a template which is given by Pega, and working, or I'm customizing the template. What are the things I need to add? Okay, so I'm using a OTB template which is already given by Pega. So I don't want to change the template. I am happy with the template. But if you don't like this template, you want to do it your own, then you have to click on convert to full section editor. So when you click on this convert to full section editor, your section looks like this. This is a full, here you have all full access to your section. You can do anything, whatever. You want to add label? Yes, you can add. You want to add layouts? Yes, you can add layouts. So anything can be possible when you convert that into section editor. But in a template, you have to use, you will be in a boundary, right? In that boundary only will be, you can do your things. Okay, so that what I'm doing, I'm going to this, yes. So what is this? This is called as table layout. Okay, so in Pega, we design the form using section. So this is our section. Okay, we design it in the section. So, and in section, if you want to arrange your properties properly, then you should have layout. Without layout, it is impossible to add properties. Can you see? I'm dragging and dropping this property down here. Can you see it is showing me what, it's showing me, it's restricting me, but inside the layout I can add anywhere. See, inside the layout I can add anywhere, right? So without layout you cannot add properties. So your layouts are for what? To properly arrange your properties. So this layout is table. Why it is table? If you look your medical history here, can you see medical history? How it is looking like? It's looking like a table, right? It's looking like rows and columns. So when do you want rows and columns? Whenever you feel that you have to repeat the same thing multiple times. Can you see? Medication. This is also medication. This is also medication. This is also medication. This is also time period. The same, and underline is also same thing. One record, you have one record which is having three columns, and the other record also having three columns. You want to repeat it. whenever it is iterating or whenever you want to add some repetitive things, then in section you have to use a column or a layout which is called as table layout, so that in the output it shows in a tabular format. So this is a tabular format. You see, if I click on this, it's gone. Okay, you can expand, you can disclose it. So this is in tabular format. This has come in a tabular format because your section is like that. Your linear section, it is shown as what? Table layout. Okay, so this is a table layout. I'm going into deep here because you may not know what how layouts looks like, but yes, I'll just stop over here. We'll talk about this again, about section and all. So understand what is table layout. So table layout, you'll have all the you'll have the properties which will be repetitive and it shows you as a rows and columns. That is one thing. And you want to add what? You want to add button. So how do you add button? There is something called as bottom here, action bottom, action top. We call them as, in table we call them as header and we call this as footer. So in the footer, let's add one button. So let me go to this. Do you have button over here? No, right? And the actions you will see. Sorry. So add button. So what is this button? This button is used for what? So when you double click on this button, it shows the cell properties, or you can right click on this settings, or click on the settings, it will show you the cell properties of button. Can you see button is this? So what you should be the caption. Caption I want. You can write your own caption over here. So sort by time period. Okay, so do you want to add any image or any iconic class? You can just select iconic class and you can search for it. I think I don't find any proper thing. Let me take this. Okay, so I took what? Iconic class. Save this. Let me check preview. Do I see anything here in the preview? Can you see down? There is some. Can you see here? I mean, hope you can see it. Can you see the icon? I mean, that image has come. Icon has come over here. Sort. Okay. Yeah, that's fine, right? Sort can be that type of image only. Fine. But what happens when you click it? So what I did, I clicked on this, I added one image source so that it will show me that image on the screen. So how it should be shown, it should, whether it should be left side or right side. I'm going with left or right, so I'll go with right so that it will show me right hand side. Then on actions, I have to configure the event. What is that? On click, it should refresh this. Refresh this section, call data transform. So which data transform? Sort medical history. Okay, submit. Save. Let's see whether it's working in our application or not. Go back. Continue. Can you see now? You got option. Can you see this symbol also? Click on this. Can you see 125 has come? Is it sorting by order? Time? Yes. How is this happening? Sorting by time. So let me write 10 over here. Sort by time. Can you see changed? Yeah. Let me write 50 here. Sort. Yes. Let me write 200, 290 something. Sort. What happened actually? So what we did here in the sort time period is, we added one button. On this button, we have written action. Under action, whenever you click on that, you refresh this section and call an activity, sorry, call a data transform which is sort medical history. What is that medical history? What you are doing here? So you have written medical history over here on settings icon. You made that it should be sorted based upon the time period, which should be ascending order. You can add anything here. You can add other thing also. So it takes AND logic over here and gives you the data, gives you the value. Okay. Underline condition, ascending, save. So go back here. Okay, so first it takes time period. Can you see? So 50, 100. So 50, 100 and all those things. So I will give this to you. So time period. Okay. So it takes time period first and then checks whether it is given properly or not. Based on that, it will give you the calls the data transform. So hope you understood now how to sort it, right? How to sort a particular page list property. Question over here is, what is the target? Whenever you use sort, what is the target? What's the target? Can you see here target? What it is showing? Page list. Okay, so sort takes what? Sort takes the page list property. So that's about one thing which we said about sort. Comment when you write something like, yeah, I'll write over here. Sibling, add sibling above. So I'll write comment. What do I write comment? Below step is used for sorting by time period. So there is no need of again checking what is there inside it, right? So this comment is helping us to tell what this step is doing. So every step is doing. Actually, in data transform, you don't know what this step is, what each and every step is used for or created for. Okay. So to make sure the other, you know, whenever someone, so who created this? Karthik has created it. For example, Jagdish want to see this because we are all working on the same thing. Okay, so if you want to check this, you need to understand why you have written second step. So to make sure, what we do is we add comment. That's again a best practice, but we don't usually follow to add comments to data transform. It's better you write in the history. What is the purpose of this whole data transform? You'll be right. This is best practice again, guys. So it's a best practice, and even when you are working, definitely you need to write this description and usage. Why? What is the purpose of using this particular data transform? So if you write it, what happens is, if someone new who has added new to your team, right? If they go and check this rule, they need to understand what is the purpose of adding this rule. So description and usage is very important. Don't forget to add this while you are working in the projects. Okay, and coming to the view fill history, it tells you what all the things happened on this particular rule, who created, when they have checked in, when they have saved it, who performed save, okay, who changed it. So this all details will be available in this view full history. Like for example, there are some 30 steps. Okay, you have created 30 steps and next day there were only 28 steps in it. So you'd be shocked, right? Why what happened to those two steps? So you just simply go and click on history and view full history. It will show you who has done those changes. And you can directly ask them, why did they delete those steps? Maybe if not required, yes, fine. So at least you'll have a, you know, you will clear your doubt, right? Why those two steps were deleted. So that history will help you a lot. Very important. So actions. So what we learned? We learned set, remove, update page, apply data transform, sort, comment. When also we learned it's a logic condition it is, true or false condition. If this is false, you'll go for otherwise when. And if this is also false, you'll go for otherwise. Next, we'll go with append to and append and map to. It's similar to your similar to update page. Okay, similar to update page, but the difference is update page is a page property, append to and append map to are page list properties. Okay, so let me add one step over here. Append to. Can you see what it is asking here? Page list. So append to means what? It will target is always page list property. So you want to append to that particular page list. From where you want to add? Maybe from one another. It can be from another page. Can you see a new page which you create, or it can be an existing page. It can be existing page, already some other page. I mean, like for example, there is a medical history here, right? So medical history is a page list property. Medical history is a page list property. Okay, and we'll go back here and check. So medical history, what did you do? You added three things here: medical, medication, time period, everything you added, and you're just continuing it and creating. So when you create, someone has to review this. So a receptionist reviewing our details. Can you see here? Yes, receptionist is reviewing. So once she reviews it, submits and checks whether doctor is available or not. So doctor, if he's available, then he or she will select the date, at what time he's available, slot date, and submits. Once submitted, it will go to the doctor approval. Okay, so doctor approval, doctor approves, yes, I am available on that day, so let him come to us. Okay, collect payment details. Yes, so we are collecting the payment also. Fine. So at this particular thing, doctor checkup. Okay, again, what happens at doctor checkup, guys? Tell me what happens. What happens is doctor will ask all the details about the patient, right? How are you and all those things? What's the problem? What's the issue? What is your previous underlying conditions? So he might be already given, but still doctor will be asking at that time. You know, this fellow might have forgot to add other thing. Maybe he's alcoholic, so he didn't add. He only added smoking, diabetic, and those things in the medical history. And now he was saying to the doctor that he's also alcoholic, which he hasn't written it. So now I have to update that also right here. So I'll update in what? I'll update in one page here. Okay, it can be in one page or in another page list. Again, I'll have medical thing over here. So now when I say medical history, all the details here, whatever he said to doctor, that in the previous medical history, both should be, you know, cumulative, means it should add, combine it. So how do you combine that? How do you combine that? Means using again data transform only. So in data transform, what you'll add? In data transform, you will use append to. So this medical history, and here it can be a page which is of doctors. Okay, at doctor place he might be adding this. So yeah, let me add that property. Okay, so let me add that property. So you'll hope you understood my requirement, right? What is my requirement here is, during doctor checkup, again this fellow is giving some medical history of his. Okay, patient forgot to give provide all the details at the time of filling the application, but now he is again giving certain medical history. So again doctor has to add those history in this particular step. So how do I add that? How do I do that? For that, again I'll create one property. I can use same property, but as it is at the doctor's time, so I want to create a new property. What is that? I'll say underline conditions. Okay. Create and open. So it should be what? It can be a page, it can be a page list. So I'll go with page list because I have maybe that fellow, my patient might be telling many things. So I'll go with page list. Okay, so let me make it as mark as relevant. Why should I do mark as relevant record, guys? If I do mark as relevant record only, I can go to the case type and add that in the configure view. If I don't do that, it won't be shown under fields. So I have written underline conditions here. Where is that? Yes. Okay, so now I got this. Okay, so let me refresh this so that my case. Okay, can you see medications already came? So now here again this fellow is giving some other things. Okay, so what he'll say that medication, yes, time period from 2 years, and he's saying alcohol. Now this particular record should be added to the medical history which he has given in the past. Okay, so this particular page, this is also page list property, right? This page list property, this row should be appended to the one which is already written or completed in the medical history. So how do I do that? So how do I do that? I have to write what? I have to go for the data transform where I write append, where I go for this what is that, data has appended to. So how do I do that? So let me go to, again, can I use the same data transform? It's, no, I can't use the same data transform because it's in something, some other what is it, what is that, it is in some other step and this is in some other step. Okay, so that's why I need to create a new data transform. What is a data transform? Add medical history. Okay, so add. So you're adding. So how do I add? I go for append to. Why append to? Whenever you want to copy data to a page list property, then you have to go for append to or append and mapped. Both are fine. Append to. So what is that property? Is medical history. Target is medical history. So do you want to go for a new page? No, I want it from the existing page. If I write existing page, I need to write page name. So if I write page name underline condition, it definitely throws me error. Why? Because underline condition is not a page, it's a page list. It's a page list property. So I can't append directly like this. Okay, I can't directly append to this medical history, right? So I can write like this one because I have only one there. So I can write like this. That will, this one becomes only one page. Okay, right. I have this. Now I will go with this data transfer. What I'm doing? I am copying certain page property data to a page list property. This is target. Target is page list property. I'm doing it. Okay, no, it's not a page, it's a page list property. Then how do I do this? Means in relation, you can all, you have seen each page in, you can use each page in also. Okay, whenever you use each page in, it will ask you whether you are using a page list property or page. Yes, page list property or page group. So yes, underline is a page list property only. So use that. So you can use it. That means what? Whatever the data is there, that will be copied into the medical history. Let's see whether it will copy or it will it will override the data. We can see, we'll see that. Okay, so it is copying into this save. So how do I invoke this? I want to invoke. See, we have seen data transform, this one we have seen, section, haven't seen this one, right? Flow action, pre and post. Let's see that. How? Where are we? We are in this particular doctor checkup. So go to live UI. See what is the flow action. Click on this table layout. On the right hand side, you can see flow action. Open this flow action. In this flow action, where did I say? In flow action, action tab. Okay, I forgot right. Okay, in flow action, action tab, pre or post. So action tab, pre or post. Can you see pre data transform is there, and post also you have data transform. Can you see post also data transform. So where do you want to write? That depends upon your case, whether after writing this, after submitting this, you want to copy the data, or before submitting only you want to copy the data. Okay, that is your requirement, right? Is it after writing or before writing? It's after writing, right? After you complete this and submit only, it should be copied. Before means, do you have any data? Before this, do you have any data? No, right? You don't have any data. After submitting only, it should be done. So after or before, pre or post. After means post, pre means before. So what is this? Is it before? No, right? It is after only. That means submit. After submitting the thing only, it should be copied. So after means post. So in your flow action, under post, you have to write the data transform. What is the data transform? Add medical history. See. Okay, save. So let's go to this and submit. Let's go back to clipboard and check what is medical history, whether it has overwritten or medical history. You got one, which is diabetic, two, which is BP, 3, which is smoking, 4, alcoholic. Got it, guys? How did we do that? Awesome, right? So there was no three, there are no, we have added only 3 things in medical history. But what we did now, you have appended the data of one page list property to the other page list property. Right, so what is the property you have there? Underline this one, right? So here, underline, select. Can you see this alcoholic has been added as a 4th page in your medical, 4th record in your medical history. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, so understood this particular append to, right? So you have appended. And another one is, there is something called as key over here. Whenever it is each page in, there is a key over here. What is this key? Key is a condition. When do you want to add? If you have any condition, you write it. So that condition you have to mention over here. For example, you want to add this only when medical history is greater than 1, or the time period is greater than 1, 2, not greater than 1, 2. Time period is greater than 2, then if you want to add it, yes, you can write there. Okay, so you don't write condition, directly write one when rule. You write one when rule. Okay, let's add. I'm just confused what we have written in the time period. Mary's clipboard. Oh, let me check clipboard. What is the property of time period? Yeah, time period T and P are capital. Okay. So let me go back here. Time period greater than 2. Only if it is greater than 2, only you add, else don't add. Okay, so that's the condition which I have written. So let's create one case. I'm using always the same thing, right? So let me create one case. So I don't want to use these all things stuff because we are working on this. So let me write medication, yes, time period is 5. This is fine. I'm not working on this, right? Because this is already there. Underline condition, smoking. Add item, yes, someone and this diabetic. Okay, so continue. So let that be there. So let me create it. So someone is reviewing our details. Let them review. Yes, 5-1, yes, submit. And doctor availability, as these are not having any validation, we are updating it. Approval, yes, approval, approving it. Collect payment details, go. So submitting it, yeah. Underline condition, yes. I will write time period as 1. If it is greater than 2 only, I said to add it. Okay, so what I'll write here is BP. I didn't write about BP there. Let me click on submit. Let's go to clipboard and check whether that is added or not. Okay, expand PA work page. Let's see what is underline actually. So underline is what? BP, time period is 1, everything is there. Let's go back to medical history. Can you see, is it added? It is smoking and it is diabetic, but nothing is added in the this particular BP is not added. Why? We have written a condition over there. What's the condition, man? What's the condition? You add only if there is a time period greater than 2. Understood? Append to? Yes, so append to is used to copy the page or page list property or a page group property into a page list property. Source can be page list or a page group, but it would be targeted into a page list property. Similar way, we have append and mapped. Append and map to is also same, similar to your append, but only the difference is the classes. Okay, if medical history and underline condition, okay, are not of same class, if they are not, these two page properties, page list properties are not from the same class. See, this is medical history. What is that? Medical history. It is coming from data dash medical history only. Good. Underline condition is also coming from medical data dash medical history only. So if both are of same class, then fine. You can go with what? You can go with append to only. But if both are of not same class, okay, if both are of not same class, okay, yeah, if both are of not same class, for example, I'm writing office address here and save. Can you see? The target and source field should be compatible. What do you mean by compatible? Compatible means, okay, let me write this existing page. Can you see append to? Whenever it is both are of compatible, compatible only can work. Okay, this target and source field should be what? Should be of same class, then only you can do append to. If both are of different classes, then you cannot do append to. Instead, you can go for append and mapped. Can you see error gone? Because append and map to works on different classes also. Understood? The page properties can be of different can reference different properties also. So now you can add dot medication. So here you can add from dot something like this. You can add directly. So you can add nicely, you can do it. Actually, I'm not creating another property, but hope you understood why I'm not creating. It's again the same thing. Okay, append and map to, same thing. Only the difference is if the source is coming from different class or referencing different class, then you cannot use that in append. Instead, append to. Instead, what you can do, you have to go for append and map to. That's it. Whatever append and append map to will do, okay, whatever the things the append and append map to will do, the same thing will be done by for each page in. Okay, so what did you do before that? You used append to, right? You used append to dot medical history and you got each page in, and there was dot time period greater than 2, right? You have this and submitted, and there was something called as sources underline condition. The same thing you can do using what? For each page, same, both are same. So here also what you'll do, you'll use dot medical history and then start writing each and everything. What? Medication. So where it should come from? It should come from each page, right? Each page of what? Each page of underlying condition. So first page means you will write as current. So whenever you write in for each page in, you don't write 1, 2, 3, 4, all those things. You'll write for each you write what? You'll write like this. Current. It is called as symbolic indexes. You have current, you have prepend, you have append, you have last. Okay, so you have these all indexes, symbolic indexes we say. So current says about the current record, first record. Then next it would be for each page, it means every record. First it takes your first record and copies that into medication. Next again, it, this is for each page, it means it's a repetitive one, for loop. You have for loop, right? So that is your for each page. Whatever you did here, the same thing it will be doing here. But you could have asked me, right? Condition, there is a condition over here, but where is your condition? Yes, you write condition, vendor. Right here. What do you write? Medical dot. It won't come up. Right here. Dot time period greater than 2. You write condition like this. If it is 2 only, it will go and add the values. If not, again it will go back to the second step. Okay, so this is for each page. You can either use append to or you can go for each page in also. If you want to, why do you want to go for each page in, and why don't you go for append to? sometimes you know after adding two or three property after adding two or three records, you want to exit from that particular page, or you want to do certain things, like you want to add something else, another property you want to add, you want to do certain other requirements, so which you cannot do from append to, because append to directly it will add all the things, even though it is condition and all those things, it will add all the data, right, all the records. But sometimes you want to abruptly exit from that. After two records only you want to exit from that append to, which you cannot do it, right? So in that situations you go for each page, and so that in the next stage you can add another in the next step you can add another properties like exit data transform or exit for each. You can directly write. So once you do it, second step exits from the for loop only. Like there might be a situation where you want to add only two records. Out of five records, you want to add only two records. Yes, use for each page in that time. You can't use append to that time, because append to will append everything. Each and every record, it will append from source to target. Okay, so that is about for each page in and exit for each. And if you want to directly exit from the data transform, you can exit from the data transform also. So this is all overall actions which we have seen in in the data transform. Understood everything, each and everything here, each and everything we learned, all 14 we learned.